And good morning. I am at the Cross Elizperp station that is Canary Wharf, the station that was finished first, and now they're having to sort of do some stuff to it because it then became unfinished to bring it up to being finished again, ready for when the line opens, we think, in April, May 2022, which is the latest speculation and rumour that I hear. But what's interesting is that even though the line isn't open yet, the fares are already in place for Crossrail, and that means that you can get a cheaper journey as of right now. So here's my Oyster card. It's one I specifically use for making journeys like this, for testing out the full price fare of something, as my normal day-to-day Oyster has a railcard discount applied, which gets me a third off. So I'm starting at Canary Wharf, onto the DLR here, which is in Zone 2, and then I headed south, down to Greenwich, change there, onto a SouthEastern train, and then I head east, for 6 stops to Plumstead. And I tap out there, and I wonder how much that's cost me.
So bright, I can't see what it says.
Ugh. So the thing you might not know is that not all Oyster and contactless fares are the same, as TfL charge you less than what several national operators do, even if you start and end your journeys in the same zone. And there's a brilliant anomaly here, because due to Crossrail being built, Abbeywood is no longer a SouthEastern station, but a TfL managed one instead. And when you go through the Oyster barrier there, you're charged a TfL scale fare. But if you tap out one before at Plumstead, which is still a SouthEastern station, but in the same Zone 4, there's a price difference.
Okay, so I have tapped out with my Oyster over there at Plumstead. It's a validator, bright sunshine. Could actually see what the display said. I'm pretty sure should be correct. It should be £2.70. Now, to save me going back to Canary Wharf and then coming back this way again to Abbey Wood, I'm going to do the same journey, but in reverse. The proof still works, because still going from A to B, from B to A, that kind of thing, which means I'm going to walk to Abbey Wood and then make the same journey back to Canary Wharf and see how much that costs. So remember, it's the same journey, just doing it B to A rather than A to B, but instead of getting out of Plumstead, I'm getting on at Abbey Wood and using the same Oyster card, and that actually works out well, because it means I want to get back to Canary Wharf, I can go to the tube ticket machines there and get a screenshot of how much everything has cost me. By the way, here, they're still pretending it's not a purple train, they've got the round all covered up, but down on the platforms, there are some purple trains in on test operations. There's one there right now that's going to Paddington. Anyway, I'm going to tap in and go back to Canary Wharf.
So I made a Zone 2 to 4 journey from Canary Wharf down here and got out at Plumstead, but for the return, I've tapped in at Abbey Wood instead, same zone they remember. And I make the return journey the same way, but in reverse, changing at Greenwich again and onto the DLR to take me right back to where I started earlier and tap out. But how much has that cost me?
So there's no sunlight on the validator reader here. I'm pretty sure that's at £1.70. All I have to do is go and use the ticket machine inside the tube station and see how much the two trips cost me.
And as I suspected would happen, the journey to Plumstead cost more. £1 more at £2.70. Whereas if you make the same journey but go one stop further, it would have cost me less, the cheaper price of £1.70.
So with the DLR behind me, it'll pop up in a second, there we have it. The reason why I can tell you is because there are 3 times a year, I think it's like January, March and September, when the fare revisions happen and new fares get put in. And Abbey Wood was always going to be like a TfL station that charged TfL fares. This just shouldn't have happened until Crossrail Elizabeth Line Cross Elizperp opened. And this was put back in place in 2018 when they thought the line was going to open in December. I think they brought it in about September of 2018. And then Crossrail was delayed, as we all know. Now it's 3 years later, 2021. It's going to be 4 years later by the time it's open, 2022. And that fare revision wasn't put back. So we should have been paying SouthEastern fares this whole time down to Abbey Wood, but it's been in place for the last 3 years. And it'll always be like it now and through when Crossrail actually starts sometime in the first 6 months of 2022. So there you go. One final thought is that if you do live in the Abbey Wood area and maybe you want to go to Abbey Wood and walk back to Plumstead, it also works going the other way. The next stop down the line is Belvedere. That would again cost you slightly more. I'll throw that on screen now. You could also consider going to Abbey Wood and then walking a little bit from Abbey Wood down towards the Belvedere direction if you really want to save money. But there you go, Crossrail fares are in place on the system already, even though the line isn't. Press subscribe. See you next time. Thank you.